I would love to see a tutorial on how to do the Black Demon Supernatural Smoke. Normally, I suppose you would use trap code, right? So yes, in an ideal world, you would use trap code particular, but I know it's expensive, so I'm going to show you a way to do it without it. Here's what the effect looked like in Supernatural. And here's what my recreation of it looks like. Now, I know it isn't perfect, but it's the best I could do without using a third-party plugin. I also apologize if this tutorial is a bit longer. I usually try to keep them under 5 minutes because I know that personally, I'm not patient enough to watch more than that, but this is a very specific effect and it has a lot of different requirements. The first step is filming your footage. There are four things I would suggest when filming to make your life easier and to make the effect come out better. Number one, film on a tripod. Number two, instruct your actor or actress not to move too much when they have their head up. Number three, use a leaf blower to make the actor's hair move when filming. The best way to sell an effect is to have it interact with the real world. And number four is to make sure the background you're shooting on isn't perfectly black in order to allow contrast with the effect. You'll see in my final shot, I made this error, and it makes the effect hard to see. If I was doing this for a film, it would be a huge mistake. But because it's just for a tutorial, I'm gonna still use the footage. Now, when we pop into After Effects, our first thing that we're gonna do is measure the duration required of the smoke. She starts to open her mouth here, and I want it to end here. So we're going to need about 3.5 seconds. We're going to then leave this for now and create a new comp titled Smoke. And duration, as we said before, needs to be 3.5 seconds. The comp size should still be 1920 by 1080, but when we go to create the new solid, we need to change those dimensions. I would suggest 1920 by 4000, and we're going to make the color of it black. I'd just like to add in here that I'm going to go through this next section pretty quickly, because I already made another tutorial on this process, and it walks you through the steps slowly. If you're more of a beginner, or if you're feeling like I'm going too fast in this section, I'll link the tutorial for you to go back and watch. So now if we zoom out, you'll see we have all this space here with this layer. We're going to select our pen tool, either by clicking here or pressing G, with Rotobezier on, and we'll create a long ellipse mask. So you should have something that looks like this. Then go into Effects and Presets and search Turbulent Displace. Drag that onto your solid. And now up in the effects controls, we're going to adjust some of the settings. Change the displacement type to twist. Amount goes to 40 and size goes to 30. Complexity also goes to 10. Bring your time indicator to the start, hit the evolution stopwatch, then bring it to the end of your comp and have it complete 10 rotations. Once you've done that, you'll notice the computer really slowing down because of the rendering. So change your quality to quarter so you can keep working quickly. Now you've got some movement, and that looks pretty good. Go into your mask dropdown and increase the feather to 30 to make it look like smoke. And now we're almost done the smoke pre-comp, but the last step is to make it move from bottom to top. Bring your time indicator to the beginning of the comp, then select the position stopwatch. Bring the entire layer down to the bottom so that it can't be seen. Then bring your time marker to the end and drag the layer to the top. And this is the result. As a really quick additional thing, I like my smoke to come in fast and leave fast. So I'm just going to drag the marker to where the smoke is fully in the frame, click this diamond here so that it makes a keyframe, and then drag that so that the layer comes in faster, like this. I'll go ahead and do the same for the end. Okay, I feel like that was a lot of information coming at you all at once, so hopefully it's okay. So now we're going to go back to our footage comp, where we are going to drag in our smoke comp. Have it start right when she begins to open her mouth. Place the bottom of the comp just below her mouth and adjust the scale to make it fit. You may have to unlink the proportionate scale here in order to make the smoke thinner. Select P for position and click the keyframe stopwatch and just go through to make sure that the smoke is always in line with her mouth. It should end up looking something like this. So this next section is all about masking. Essentially, we are going to mask her bottom lips and jaw so that in the end, it makes it look like it's coming out of her mouth. I know that many people already know how to mask and mask track, so if you do, feel free to skip ahead to the next section. So first, you're going to duplicate your footage layer and then drag it on top of the smoke. For this section, I hid the smoke comp so that it doesn't get in the way. We're going to go where she has her mouth fully open. Now, using our pen tool, we're going to block out her bottom lip and jaw. You can have the bottom part go out like this. It just needs to cover up the smoke comp. Make sure when you're blocking out the lips, you're precise, making sure you're placing it just on the edges. Okay, perfect. Now, as much as we told our actress to hold still when shooting, it's impossible to have her hold perfectly still. So we're going to use After Effects tracking tool to have it do most of the work for us. You'll see here I have the tracker window pulled up, and these are all the options available. If you can't find it, just go to the top, select Window and Tracker. So these options here are not what we want to use. We need to go into our mask options and click the mask path, and you'll see the track options change. If you click this play button here, you'll see that the program automatically will move the mask with her mouth. It inevitably will fall off, but all you need to do is go to where it starts to make the mistake, adjust it, then click play again. After that looks good, go to where the keyframes start, and then start tracking backwards. Because of how much the mouth moves at the beginning, you might need to track more by hand. Nice, okay, this is looking good. So when you reveal the smoke comp again, you'll see that it appears like it's coming out of her mouth. This step will probably take the most amount of time, because the more precise the masking is, the better the effect will look. Again, I'm going to speed over this part because it's in the last tutorial, but I added a smoke cloud to the top so it looks like the smoke is condensing. So, new solid, mask a square, turbulent displace, complexity to 10, evolution keyframes, feather, then mask path. There, just like this. So then to make the smoke a little more dynamic, I want to make the top of it move a little bit. Select the smoke pre-comp and then select the puppet tool, which is located up here. Then what you're going to do is make 5 points along the line here. The bottom two should never move because it needs to stay in line with her mouth. However, you can then keyframe the top three and move it in any way you want. By coming to Effects, Puppet, Mesh 1, Deform, and then opening your puppet pins, you'll be able to see the keyframes as you move the points around. And there, see how the top of the smoke is now moving? I have another tutorial on how to use the puppet tool, which I will also put a link to if you need more assistance. The final thing which I added to the clip is a simple camera shake in order to make it seem like the demon is affecting the entire world. First, create a null object. Then, create a camera layer. Now, the camera layer can only affect 3D objects, so click here to make everything 3D. If you can't find this button, chances are you're just in blending mode, so click this button here and you'll see it. With the camera layer, make its parent layer the null object. Next, go to the null object's layer position, hold Alt for Windows or Option for Mac, and press the stopwatch. You'll see that this will pop up, and in it we're going to type wiggle, bracket, 10, 5, bracket. Now this wiggle will appear for the entire clip. So to edit that, simply drag the camera layer so it only starts where you want the shake to happen. Do the same with the ending. And there you go. Let me know in the comments if this was helpful or if you would have preferred a longer version where I explained every step. I try in my tutorials to make things concise and understandable, but this just had so many steps that made it a little complicated. Feel free to ask any questions or send requests in the comment section below as well. Thanks for watching and hope this helped.